Let's begin by going behind the scenes of Fox's surprise ouster of Lou Dobbs. It's not cancel culture here, it is consequence culture. What are the consequences for riling up people with reckless lies about a democracy that most Americans cherish? Well, lately there have not been many consequences, but maybe that's changing. Maybe. The pro-Trump love-in, the lie fest known as Lou Dobbs Tonight, was canceled on Friday, one day after Dobbs was singled out in a $2.7 billion lawsuit from the voting tech company Smartmatic. The company alleges that Fox and Dobbs and Sidney Powell and Rudy Giuliani all waged a disinformation campaign against the company in a desperate bid to keep Trump in power. There are other lawsuits coming too. And we're going to get to those in a little bit with a spokesman for another company that was smeared by the likes of Dobbs. But here's the thing. Yeah, Dobbs is off the air, but Jeanine Pirro was named in the Smartmatic lawsuit too. So was Maria Bartiromo. And as you can see, they were both on the air, back on the air this weekend. Fox is vowing to fight the Smartmatic lawsuit. And I'm told that the plan to cut Dobbs loose was in the works before Smartmatic filed in court. So then why was Dobbs dismissed? Why isn't Fox explaining it? What does this tell us about Fox's direction in the post-Trump age? What pressure is Fox feeling from networks like Newsmax? And how significant could all these lawsuits potentially be? I have four great guests standing by with answers. So let's begin with David Folkenflik. He's the media correspondent for NPR News. He's been all over this story. And Dana Young, she's a professor of communications and political science at the University of Delaware. David, why was Lou Dobbs canceled on Friday night?
Well, it wasn't ratings. I mean, the man was among the leaders for the Fox Business Network. Fox officials are telling me, I'm sure they're telling you, hey, look, we announced in October we were going to make a bunch of changes. This is just one of them. Yet it happened very abruptly, not a seamless handoff. I think that you saw a guest host sit in on Thursday night saying you'll see Lou tomorrow, and you sure didn't see Lou Dobbs Friday night. And it was, as you pointed out in your introduction, just 24 hours or so after this filing of this $2.7 billion, with a B, billion-dollar lawsuit, right? Dobbs, it seems to me, was in some ways the avatar of this, what should be a scandal for Fox News. They ran these crazy little two and a half minute correctives, in a sense, on Dobbs's show and Pirro's show and Bartiromo's show, which viewers would have been hard pressed to make any sense of as a fact check because it never referred to Fox or its previous reporting. And in addition, this reminds me a little bit, to be honest, of the way in which scandals were handled at Rupert Murdoch's news tabloids in London. You and I had to handle it about a decade ago, right, where what they would do is they would throw somebody over the side and see if that was enough. And it seems to me that this is an effort to cauterize the wound, to distance Fox from this feverish conspiracy theory with consequences, as opposed to so many of the conspiracy theories that are ventilated on Fox that might not play out this severely. This really did have a severe and deleterious effect on the American public's understanding of the election that just happened and influenced, in some regard, the way in which people arrived at those protests on January 6th. I think that it's going to be hard for Smartmatic to prove that there was a correlation legally, but it doesn't mean there isn't a journalistic obligation for Fox to try to handle that in a responsible way, which they sure didn't do.
And your point about News of the World and what happened with Murdoch's British tabloids, it does seem like a similarity here. Your book about that, Murdoch's World, is an essential read, by the way. Just want to make people know they can order it on Amazon. Dana, here's what I kind of see going on. Tell me if I'm crazy about this, okay? In the reality-based community, right, Biden is president. Trump is off in exile in Mar-a-Lago, pretty much silent. And yet the Trump fan base wants to watch shows that tell them unreality, that tell them a fantasy about how Biden stole the election and how Democrats are evil. And so there's the real market demand for shows like Lou Dobbs. And yet, shows like Lou Dobbs can also get you into legal jeopardy. They can also cause advertisers to flee because they don't want to be associated with the nonsensical content that's going to embarrass their brands. So there's this tension between what the audience, the right-wing audience, wants and what networks are going to give them versus what's actually in the business interests of those networks. Am I getting that right?
Yeah, first of all, you're not crazy.
Okay.
Second of all, in terms of the source of this demand, where does the demand come from in the first place? Is it organic demand on the part of these viewers? Or is this demand that has resulted from the cultivation of this sort of distrust that has happened over the last several decades. Also, I just want to say lawsuits have a way of forcing people and entities to reckon with empirical fact and reality, because the judicial system is predicated on evidence, empirical, verifiable reality. And when you're looking at the conservative media ecosystem, their sort of dominant lens is one that's driven kind of by truthiness and intuition and gut and what feels right. And they're able to sort of cloak themselves in the First Amendment, right, freedom of speech. And because these programs are opinion and analysis shows that, by the way, Fox does everything that it can to try to hide that fact from the viewers. Viewers would be hard-pressed to recognize the distinction between the analysis programming and the news programming. And journalism as a profession has reputational and professional norms that are self-corrective in a way that outrage and opinion programming does not.
Right. That's absolutely right. Look at what happened on Fox's opinion shows the other night. There was this ceremony at the Capitol for the slain U.S. Capitol police officer. MSNBC and CNN were showing it live, of course, because that's what all television networks would do, news networks would do. And Fox just stuck with its hardcore right-wing talk and just barely dipped in for a few seconds when Biden was there to pay his respects. But these are not choices of a news network. These are, David Folkenflik, it occurs to me that Fox News is afraid of the news. Like, they're avoiding the news. They don't want to cover the news because their viewers don't want to hear it or don't want to see it, well, even when it's about a police officer.
I think that you've basically got that right. They may have dipped into that, but not in the way that other news networks did.
Right.
I think that, you know, what you're seeing is Fox is being led by its viewers right now. It doesn't have a clear sense of how it wants to operate in the post-Trump world when Trump still commands so much loyalty from its core viewers.
Right.
And I think what you're really seeing is a dangerous element where Fox isn't in control. It has yielded so much of its news program to its opinion hosts and opinions anyways, fusing them with segments from some of their most outspoken figures in its way of kind of serving up red meat. And it's to the great frustration of the journalists who remain.
So, Dana, when you heard Marjorie Taylor Greene say the other day that, you know, that she was allowed to believe things that aren't true. That's the entire basis of the wild right-wing media universe. These conspiracy theories and things that aren't true that stick in the minds of tens of millions of people. What can we learn from psychology about the power of these conspiracy theories?
So recognize that her language, when she said, I was allowed to, before she said that, right before she said, because I was upset about things and didn't trust the government, because people here were not doing the things they should be doing, the problem with that is I was allowed to believe things that weren't true. Now, let's talk for a second about she didn't trust the government, didn't trust the media. She deals with those things as factual and deserved, that they're appropriate responses to her direct experience with the world. And she talks about sort of being maligned for her views. The question I ask you is, what are the dominant themes of Fox News programming? Those are the themes. Distrust in media, distrust in the government, and the notion that you, for being conservative and because of your values, are socially maligned and looked at with contempt by the left, by liberals, by media, and by other institutions in the world. So she kind of got close when she talked about this, and those three things really are the special sauce that kicks off an interest in conspiracy theories. Conspiracy theories are really tempting for individuals who have this sort of need to understand the world in a gut-driven way.
And
if they're socially maligned, if they distrust institutions in power, and if you consistently reinforce that sense and consistently plant the seeds of distrust by hinting at conspiracy theories, and note that Fox doesn't start them, they simply amplify them. They amplify them. And I guess I just thought it was interesting because when she framed how she ended up becoming Q curious, it actually was a quite accurate depiction of how it happens. But she didn't quite go far enough in explaining where the roots of that distrust lie. And I would argue that they come through the conservative media ecosystem.
And that's what I want to underscore here. Dobbs is going away. That's one show on one channel. There are many other shows like him. There is no sign that Fox is moving toward the center, back to the kind of the centrist, you know, reality-based middle. No sign of that at all. Dobbs seems like an anomaly. And I think he was partly dismissed just because management had had enough of him. They were just tired of his BS. But they've got a lot of other people there selling the same stories. All right. Dana, thank you. Yeah, David, one last thought. Yeah.
What I was just going to say was, don't forget, Maria Bartiromo is technically under the news division. I've asked this question repeatedly of Fox. She's supposedly straight news, and yet she's amplifying these conspiracy theories just the same.
Right, and she's named in the Smartmatic suit just like Dobbs.